Welcome to another video of Python, specifically Python with Spider. Today we're gonna have a look at lists. Lists are a type of variable where instead of having only one variable like x or y or z or number or whatever, now we're gonna have multiple numbers. So it's a list of numbers. We call this also an array, but we'll it's similar to an array in used in other programming languages. And what we basically have, one variable is like one position in memory, right? So it's like a drawer. We can have a drawer and put something in the memory and then close the drawer and then it's in the memory. When you have a list, then it's actually multiple positions in memory. So basically it's like a closet with multiple drawers. So how do we program that in Python? Well, we're gonna make a new variable. We have to give it a name, so for instance something like numbers, I don't know. And we do it like this. We can here indicate the numbers. For instance, I'm starting with a 3, then I've got a 65, then I've got a 4, and then I've got a 90, and maybe I've got a 23.01. Let's see if this is okay. Yeah, it doesn't give an error. Well, how do I now access these numbers? I can access them like this, numbers, and then I'm gonna have the square brackets again, and if I want to have the first number, then I have to put in 0. So now if I run it, what does it give? It gives 3, because that's the first number, so you start counting from 0. So if I want to have this number, that's the fourth number, so that's 0, 1, 2, 3. So let's see if I can get 90. Yes, I can get 90. So this is pretty useful, especially if we want to store a lot of numbers. Or data, actually, because we can use this also like for this. We can also store different kind of data. We can also store, for instance, names. And if I now print out the second name, then I expect that we will see Pete. Yes, indeed. There's one even more nice way of using these kind of lists, and that's in the following. And then I'm gonna combine it with a for loop. For e in range, and then I'm gonna say length of name. Yeah, and then I'm gonna say print name. And now I'm gonna do something special. Instead of putting there a number, I'm gonna put a variable, namely the variable I. And I'm gonna remove these previous prints for clarity. So what I'm doing now, I'm gonna print all the names with different I's, or basically I'm gonna first print the first one, so 0, name 0, then 1, then 2, etc. So let's see if this works. And indeed, I can, what you see here, I can print out different names in a very compact statement. Okay, let's go to the next movie.